Welcome back to this edition of our show From Logo to Impact. Now, it is India's largest car maker by volume, with sales of 1.2 lakh units just last month. Maruti Suzuki has certainly been making some bold new bets in the year gone by. First, with its launch of their premium sales channel, Nexa. And then the second bet, which is a slew of new products like the Baleno and the S-Cross. And of course, the slightly older Celerio, which has been a volume puller for the company. Joining us on the show right now is R.S. Kalsi. He's the Executive Director of Marketing and Sales at Maruti Suzuki. Great to have you with us, Mr. Kalsi, and welcome to this edition of our show From Logo to Impact. Why don't you start off by telling us about your new brand campaign, Aaj Ke Zamane Ki Leap, for your popular hatchback, the Celerio. What's the thought and the insight that's driving this campaign?
Well, I would like to say that Celerio lives up to its brand promise that life takes a leap in the life of the customers. And Celerio has been a game changer from that point of view. We did a research into the life of the customers who were buying our cars. And what we found was that the in-depth study on Celerio customer profile indicated that it is being purchased by consumers with more progressive outlook. They are open to new technologies and they believe in doing the experimentation and they love the gizmos. At the same time, all this approach is reflected in their lifestyles as well. And based on these customer insights, in fact, we wanted to design a more consumer-oriented campaign talking about this evolved, progressive customer mindset.
Okay, so what marketing mix have you opted for with this campaign, Mr. Kalsi? Which medium is going to be the focus of your ad spends for it?
Well, we are going in for integrated media mix, and we have two brand new campaigns which you have already seen on television. The third is about to come.
Okay, but I have to ask you about your digital marketing. How important is it for a car brand like yours to up its investments on the digital medium right now? If you can walk us through some of your recent initiatives in that space.
We are going in for 360-degree campaigns, and we are giving a lot of importance to the digital media as well. And other media that we are going to use is radio, outdoors, and the BTL activities. As far as digital is concerned, in India today we have about 150 million people who are using the smartphones, and 93% of them are on the social media. And these are people who are quite tech savvy, and they are the ones who would like to go in for these new high technology products. And I would like to mention here that we created a Celerio website when we launched it, and it was a first of a kind approach, and we received 3.2 million website visits in a short span of less than 1.5 years, and about 2 lakh websites website visits are happening per month in the current scenario. Also, we went in for diesel launch with the live webcast for the first time on MSN, and it was viewed by 6 lakh people.
Over the last 2 months, Mr. Kalsi, you've had a high octane campaign for the Baleno. So what kind of ad spends have been involved in this, and did it really get you the kind of impact you had aimed for? Did it help give sales at your Nexa showrooms a boost?
Having launched the Nexa channel in the first phase through S-Cross, subsequently the Baleno was the second product, and it's a premium hatchback with high technology and excellent fuel mileage, be it petrol model or diesel model. We actually went in for a big high impact campaign on this, and it had its own effect, so much so that in about a month's time we got 100,000 inquiries. So as many customers visited our showrooms, and they looked at the product, they appreciated the kind of premium treatment that we had planned to give them on the Nexa showrooms. Today we have 35,000 bookings of Baleno, which we captured in a single month. So this campaign had its desired impact, and the product has been liked by the customers in a big way.
So if you go to see this S-Cross and the Baleno, these are your two cars that are available only in Nexa showrooms. But given that Maruti Suzuki has always been seen as India's quintessential mass car maker, Tell us if this strategy to make it exclusive worked out for you. What kind of response have you received so far?
Well, I would like to say that initially we had a challenge that customers, they had apprehensions about the success of Nexa channel, like you rightly asked. And we started with 80 showrooms, while we have 1,700 odd existing showrooms as well. So we made a hub and spoke arrangement where, wherein even if there is no Nexa showroom in a particular place, the existing showrooms can capture the inquiries from the customer, and they will like to take the customer to the Nexa showroom to give him that experience. So I would like to say that it's not a, you know, this thing, handicap anymore, and our escrows numbers are in line with our optimistic estimates, as it's a crossover. And Maruti Suzuki has for the first time introduced a real crossover in its portfolio. And I would like to say that it's a wonderful vehicle with all the comfort and sophistication of a sedan, and all the ruggedness and high power of an SUV. And it is certainly creating a delight to the customers, people who have bought it. And moving forward, we expect that this product will take off, and we will certainly touch, you know, higher numbers.
I remember in one of your recent interviews, you'd said that at least 50% of the market is still out of your purview. Now we're almost 5 months after the Nexa initiative has started. Tell us if the situation has changed on the ground.
I would like to say that our focus on the premium segment as well as the premium customers has really increased. As a result of this, as I mentioned earlier, we have been able to get about 35,000 bookings of Baleno, and we have been able to clock on, an average sale of S-Cross as well to the tune of about 3,000 per month on an average so far. So certainly a customer who looks forward to premium treatment at the showroom, and he embraces technology, he loves digital interaction, he likes pampering, he looks forward to a relationship manager handling all his car-related requirements through a single window. So this is the, you know, class of customers who is actually appreciating Nexa, and certainly it is helping us expand our market.
Right. And if you can tell us, what are some of the interesting BTL activities and sales promotions that you've engineered now to increase your engagement with the consumer?
Well, lot of activities, and in fact, we have engaged all our field teams in carrying out the BTL activities. Some of these being, we approach the corporates wherein we organize special service camps, and when say monsoon season approaches, we organize service camps across the country for our customers, wherein we do their tire checking, brake checking, and as the summer season approaches, we go in for air conditioner checking, and we do this kind of activities to support the customers. And apart from this, we organize various vehicle display activities at the premium malls, and also we had a special truck which had been designed like a typical Nexa showroom. It was taken from place to place, wherein at the high-end malls this was showcased to the customers, and this also was equipped with Google glasses, wherein the customer could see the showroom in its virtual form. So these are some of the activities that we keep doing.
Of course, while you're one of the leaders in the domestic passenger vehicle market, Mr. Kalsi, how have you fared in this premium segment that you're targeting? That has been a bit troublesome for the brand, hasn't it?
Well, I would like to say that we are gradually evolving. You see, we started with the Desire sedan version of A3 minus segment, I would like to say, where the market was limited to a few thousand numbers. And today we have been able to create and develop the market, wherein in the entry-level sedan segment, we are selling close to 24,000 vehicles per month. So likewise, we entered into A3 premium segment, A3 plus segment through SIAZ, and today we are doing more than 5,000 numbers per month. So we are creating segments, and gradually as the market is evolving, we are moving upwards in terms of our products.
Mr. Kalsi, a lot hinges on festive season sales. So tell us how the festive season has been this time in terms of sales for Maruti Suzuki.
Well, I would like to say that festival season had been very good for us, and we started preparations much in advance, and it started with the Onam down south, wherein we had very good sales, and subsequently, you know, in the central India, western India, we had Ganpati festival, and then Navratras in the northern India, and Diwali. So if we compare festival season to festival season, we had about 17 to 18% growth. And actually, as I mentioned, we started preparing for this festival season, and we created a lot of festivities around our products. During this period, we started with our Wagonr in the automatic gear shift version. Also, we launched the Altiga with the hybrid version, and we also brought in hybrid version on Ciaz, and we brought in say limited editions of Alto K10. As well as we introduced the Swift Glory, a special festival edition. So like this, we created a lot of excitement and around our products. So it was the festival season sentiment supported by the strong excitement around our products, which led to this kind of growth.
Fair enough. Thanks very much for joining us, Mr. Kalsi. And here's wishing you all the best for the future as well.
Thank you.
We'll take a quick break now. But after that, when we return, we break down IDEA's latest ad campaign. And also do stay with us for that rib-tickling humorous ad of the week. We'll be right back.